Digital Technology, Process and Application. Biotechnology is a branch of biology which deals with the techniques of using live organisms, enzymes or biological processes to produce products and provide services for human welfare. So first, recombinant DNA technology. It is the technology of manipulating the genome of a cell or organism so as to change the phenotype desirably. The basic steps involved are isolating genomic DNA of a donor. The cell or organism from which the required gene is taken is the donor. Then fragmenting this DNA using molecular scissors, that is enzymes. Screening the fragments for a desired gene. Inserting the fragments with desired gene into a cloning vector, a plasmid, cosmid or fake DNA, so as to develop a recombinant DNA. Introducing the recombinant vector into a competent host cell. Culturing these cells to obtain multiple copies or clones of desired fragment of DNA. Using these copies to transform suitable host cells so as to express the desired gene. And the tools used for this are enzymes. The restriction endonucleases are used to cut DNA at specific points. Vectors are the DNA molecules used to transfer genetic material into another cell. The cloning vectors must be able to replicate in the host cell. Insertion of a vector into the target cell is usually called transformation for bacterial cells, transfection for eukaryotic cells, although insertion of a viral vector is called transduction. Baculovirus is useful in insects. Tiplamid is for plants and YAC, that is yeast artificial chromosome, is for yeast cell. Now about the process. DNA taken from both the sources is fragmented by restriction endonuclease. The ends of the cut are called sticky ends. These are able to base pair with any DNA fragment that contains the complementary sticky end. Then, transposons, plasmids, and bacteriophages. Transposons are sequences of DNA that can move or transpose themselves to new positions within the genome of a single cell. So these are also jumping genes. On the basis of their mechanism, they are classified into two types. First one, retrotransposons. They copy in two stages. First, from DNA to RNA by transcription and then from RNA back to DNA by reverse transcription. Then DNA transposons, they do not involve RNA intermediate. Plasmids are the small extra-chromosomal double-stranded circular forms of DNA that replicate autonomously. They are naturally found in bacteria, yeast, and occasionally in plant and animal cells. A bacteriophage is a virus that infects bacteria. It consists of an outer protein capsid enclosing the genetic material. Larger DNA molecules can be injected in host bacterial cell by bacteriophages. The portion of phage DNA required for packing it in a capsid is retained and virulent portion is deleted so that desired DNA fragment can be loaded. Then phage lambda as vector. The cohesive cos ends allow the DNA to be circularized in the host cell. The recombinant DNA is then packaged within viral particles in vitro and these are allowed to infect bacterial cells which have been cultured on agar. Now, replication of bacteriophages. Replication of bacteriophages inside the specific host or bacterial cell takes place in following steps. First is attachment. Bacteriophages attach to specific receptors on the surface of bacteria. 2. Penetration. The tail fibers bring the base plate closer to the surface of the cell. Once attached completely, the tail contracts, injecting genetic material, that is DNA, through the bacterial membrane. Capsid, that is protein coat, remains outside and is called host. Then synthesis of proteins and nucleic acids. The host normal synthesis of proteins and nucleic acid is disrupted and it is forced to manufacture viral DNA and proteins instead. Then virion assembly. The base plates are assembled with the tail first. The head's capsids are constructed separately and then are joined with the tails. The DNA is packed efficiently within the heads. Then release of virions. Phages are released via lysis of cell. Release virions are capable of infecting a new bacterium. Now about restriction fragments. A restriction fragment is a DNA fragment resulting from the cutting of a DNA strand by the restriction enzyme, that is restriction endonucleases or RENAs, a process called restriction. Now types of REN. Three main types, type 1, type 2 and type 3 are known. They have slightly different modes of action. Then nomenclature. Restriction endonucleases are named by a standard procedure with particular reference to the bacteria from which they are isolated. The first letter in italics of the enzymes indicates the genus name, followed by the first two letters also in italics of the species. Then comes the strain of the organism and finally a Roman numeral indicating the order of discovery. For example, E. coli RI is from Escherichia E. coli, that is CO, strain RY13, so capital R, and first endonuclease 1 to be discovered. Then recognition sequences. Recognition sequence or restriction site is the site where the DNA is cut by a restriction endonuclease. Restriction endonucleases specifically recognize DNA with a particular sequence of 4 to 8 nucleotides and cleave. Most restriction sites are palindromes. In a palindrome, base sequence of second half in DNA strand represents the mirror image of the base sequence of first half. Then cleavage pattern. In recombinant DNA technology, specific restriction endonucleases, particularly type 2, recognize a specific base pair in DNA called a restriction site and cleave the DNA within the sequence by hydrolyzing the phosphodiester bonds, retaining symmetry, and isolate a particular gene so that the double-stranded restriction fragments have single-stranded ends. Many cuts are made by one restriction enzyme because of the chances of repetition of these sequences in a long DNA molecule. Then preparing and cloning a DNA library. First type, genomic library. It is a collection of all clones of DNA fragments that represent the complete genome of an organism. For construction of genomic library of an organism, its entire genome, that is DNA, is isolated and cut into fragments using suitable restriction endonuclease. These fragments are then inserted into cloning vectors. The recombinant vectors are then transferred into suitable organism such as bacteria or yeast. Screening for the desired gene can be done through complementation or using probes. Then cDNA library. cDNA is complementary DNA. It is produced using mRNA by the process called reverse transcription. The process is taminism, named after its discoverer Tamin. Then gene amplification, PCR. Gene amplification is obtaining multiple copies of a known DNA sequence that contains a gene. Gene amplification can be done artificially by using polymerase chain reaction, that is PCR technique. The vast majority of PCR methods use thermal cycling, that is alternately heating and cooling the PCR sample. The three essential steps of PCR technique are, first, heat denaturation. This step involves heating of DNA at about 91 degrees Celsius. 2. Annealing. It is pairing of primers to the ssDNA segment. 3. Polymerization. The temperature is raised to 72 degrees Celsius. These three steps constitute one cycle of the reaction. The process is carried out for about 28 to 30 cycles, beyond which its reliability decreases. PCR technique is used in medical and biological research labs for a variety of applications. It is used in DNA cloning, gene amplification, DNA-based phylogeny, or functional analysis of genes, diagnosis of hereditary diseases, DNA fingerprints used in forensic sciences and paternity testing, and diagnosis of cancer. Now, application of biotechnology in agriculture, BT crops. To increase the food production, there are three options: use of chemical fertilizers and pesticides, use of biopesticides and biofertilizers, that is organic farming, and use of genetically engineered crop plants, that is transgenic plants or BT crops. These plants carrying desirable traits like disease resistance, insect resistance and herbicide resistance are produced. Plants with better photosynthetic efficiency, nitrogen fixing ability, improved storage proteins and higher vitamin content can be produced. Bacillus thuringiensis (BT) is a soil bacterium that produces a protein with insecticidal qualities. An insecticidal spray produced from these bacteria is used. The activated toxin causes swelling in the gut and death of the insect. The examples are BT corn, rice, tomato, potato, and soybean. Then Agrobacterium tumefaciens. It is a soil bacterium which causes crown gall tumors in dicotyledonous plants. A gall-producing gene, tDNA, occurs in a large plasmid called tumor-inducing plasmid or TI plasmid. It is most widely used for gene transfer. For example, golden rice is genetically engineered rice with greater pro-vitamin A, that is beta-carotene content. Then, biosafety issues. Genetic modification of organisms can have unpredictable effects when such organisms are introduced into ecosystem. So, there are issues regarding biopiracy also. A biopatent is a patent granted by the government to the inventor for biological entities, processes, and products. Patent gives the owner exclusive rights to use the resource, process, or market the product and earn profits. For example, basmati rice, known for its unique aroma and flavor, has been grown in India for centuries. A Texas-based company got patent rights on basmati rice through the US patent and allowed the company to sell a new variety of basmati known as Texmati.